Carmelo. And it seems even more remote that Melo would go to Cleveland. But it feels like, one, they're getting a divorce, right? He's going to be moved from the Knicks. That's not. I'm not getting the wrong feelings, am I?
No, you're not getting the wrong feeling because they obviously want to move him, and there are a few places he would go. I'm with you. I don't see him going to Cleveland because the Cavs rightly won't give up Kevin Love. The place could be the Clippers. Now, there's a report out that they've been talking about a deal that we don't know how far along it is, but that they're talking about a deal where the Clippers would be able to get Melo and keep Blake, DeAndre Jordan, and Chris Paul. Now, that would mean basically you'd have to do it for Jamal Crawford and Austin Rivers. And I've been talking to some people for a few days now, and I've heard rumblings like that. Now, I don't know how serious it is. The question a lot of people are throwing out is, would Doc Rivers trade his son? And my thing is, that makes no sense for the Knicks because both Crawford and Rivers have 2 years left on their deal after this year. So, look, if the Clippers could get Melo without breaking up their big three, I'd do it. Now, how's it going to work? I don't know. You work that out. You're Doc Rivers. You work it out. But that's your only chance of getting closer to the Warriors, I believe. Now, another team is Boston. Boston could give up, you know, Amir Johnson, Jonas Jerebko, who have expiring deals totaling $17 million. And then Jay Crowder, and then a draft pick, not one of the ones from the Nets, which will be a top three pick, but one of their own. And the question is, does Boston want to go in that direction?
Does Brad Stevens want to coach Carmelo Anthony?
Yes, that's what. Now, my feeling is this. That doesn't put you above Cleveland either, but it makes you a legitimately elite team now. If you get Melo with Isaiah Thomas.
But why? Melo's on the Knicks, and they have Derrick Rose and Kristaps Porzingis. They're not an elite team. Why would adding him to the Celtics make them an elite team?
Well, Rose, I mean, come on. He's not what he used to be. Isaiah Thomas.
I understand. The problem is, like, we're looking at Carmelo through, like, the glasses of 5 years ago, aren't we?
I think he can still be a productive player. To your point, he's at his best in the Olympics when he's like the third best player on the floor,
right?
And all he has to do is worry about scoring. That's why,
the Clippers make sense. Clippers make sense.
Kevin Love for him, but part of me would like to see him in Cleveland, but I can't. There's no way I give up Love for him.